Well, the first Maravillas would be that were actually, you know, here would be El Hoyo, Kern, Lomita, Lote. La Primera was one of them. I don't know if I said Kern Maravilla, Ford Maravilla. Yeah, those were the first to establish the grounds right here. But prior, before that, all those cliques, we were just Maravilla. It was just a town. And where are you from? I'm from Maravilla. I stay in Maravilla. And so that's where you're known. Until later on, they put a thing. Well, where do you stay at? Well, I stay in the hole, which was El Hoyo. Where do you stay at? Oh, I stay on that side on you know, where Ford Boulevard's at. So you're considered for Ford. And that's how those names came to be.
Now, can we talk a little bit about your skills as a tattoo artist? Right. And how did that develop? Where did you first learn about tattoos?
So I first learned about tattoos from my uncle Pajaro from El Hoyo. When I was young, like I said, I used to watch my dad run around, and he would go to his brother's house, which was my uncle. And I would go over there, and I'd always see a lot of homeboys from different barrios, from the SGV area down to the, you know, the San Fernando area. These were all dudes that were in prison with them. And he would be tatting on them. My uncle was an amazing artist. And he used to do a lot of tattoos, you know, where there were just dots. He would pick at their back or their arms, and it was just all, when you looked at it, it was like, you know, it looked from far, it looked like a regular machine, but when you look close at it, it was like nothing but dots. And a lot of homeboys that would come and get these pieces on them, which a lot of it was cultura, you had to be vouched for to get this stuff. You couldn't just go into a tattoo shop and get, you know, these Aztec pieces or Mayan pieces on you. You had to be spoken for. And so a lot of them, you know, they went to my uncle to get it. You know, I would sit there for hours just watching them, you know, pick at their skin, and he would be explaining to me what these pieces meant. And I always said, I want to be that person. I want to be like that. And he started teaching me how to make a machine from taking apart a Walkman. And, you know, you get a spoon and a big pan and poke the little ball out.
Wait up.
And
a lot of youngsters aren't going to know what a Walkman is.
Right. That's right.
A Walkman.
Yeah.
Tell us what a Walkman is.
So a Walkman, back in the 90s, you know, there were Sony Walkmans, Iowas, and they held a cassette. And you used to put them, you know, in your pocket or your back pocket and, you know, bump your favorite music. And so there's a little motor inside the Walkman. And you would take it out, and it has a little motor that spins, and you would connect it to either a double D battery, two of them, duct tape them together, get yourself a little wire and a guitar string, whether it's, I think it was a number 5 or a number 3 guitar string, because it couldn't be the thickest one. And then just get yourself a little sharpener and sharpen it and start, you know, poking at the skin, creating your piece.
So someone has to be bold enough to be the first one you tat on, right? Because
right,
there's no way you're gonna be good the first time you do it.
Right. Yeah. My first tattoo was actually on some girl, and she got this tattoo from my cousin. My cousin did a tattoo on her, and I was telling her, man, that dude really fucked you up. Like, how come you didn't get at me to do your tattoo? And she goes, oh, I didn't know you knew how to tat, and I never tatted before, but I knew how to make a machine. And so I'm like, just come to my pad, you know, I got you. So I ended up making a machine real quick. And I tatted a name on her, and I was surprised. And she goes, damn, it came out better than your cousin. And that kind of motivated me, you know, to keep this going. So it was a weekend thing. And over the years, it just became, when it started becoming harder to get jobs for me because of tattoos and gangs and record and stuff like that, then I just started doing full-on tattooing and to where I'm at today, you know, Marvelous Ink Tattoos.
So why was it so hard for you to get a job?
Because of your record and your appearance, you know, I had a lot of hard time with just how you look. And then I didn't always know how to, I was nervous going into interviews, you know. I didn't really speak up and say I knew this or I knew that. I would just let them ask me questions and be like, yeah or yes. And, you know, now I know, you know to show yourself, you know, and speak up for yourself when it comes to that. But I guess we're all a little bit, when we're younger, intimidated by these big old corporations that we're trying to get into.
And what's it like when you decide I'm about to blast the face?
I don't know. It's kind of like it's kind of like, damn, you know what? You have to be, I'm probably not going to ever get a real job again. Or people are going to look at me different. But to me, growing up, it's like people were already always looking at me different anyways. You know, I've always been like, you know, people are always trying to put you down or fight with you. Or, you know, because you're from this barrio. So I really grew up being against the grain. So it's like, you know, pretty much fuck it.
Thanks for watching StreetTV.net. If you're not subscribed, please hit that button below and click the bell to receive alerts and notifications. Feel free to comment below so you can give us your feedback, and be sure to watch the two related episodes to the right. If you want to support this platform or follow us on social media, visit the links in the description. And thanks for watching StreetTV.net.